Hi there, my name is Sockie. Welcome back to the Gameazons channel, and you are watching part 5 of my Trine Enchanted Edition playthrough. We're gonna just resume right here, start it off. I'm gonna skip all this dialogue, so that's a thing. And just a little reminder, I'm still working with my beautiful tendonitis wrist, so I might be a little bit, the video might be a little bit shorter. Sorry about that, but that's kind of where we're at right now. So where we left off last time, as everyone kind of knows, I've been more or less ignoring the storyline, which isn't the greatest way to do things, but the dialogue options are quite lengthy, and I just haven't, I'm not able to talk while I listen. That's a skill I don't have, so I've just been kind of going forward and not worrying about that kind of thing just right now. But as I understand it, we're still looking for the Trine, which is some kind of magical artifact. Currently, the adventurers that I'm with, I have this thief lady, and her powers are wonderful. She has a bow that can shoot 2 arrows at a time, and she has her little grappling hook. I've got my knight character, who is, sword and shield kind of guy, and then I also have this wizard, who is probably my favorite to use, just because he's so useful. He's got his little magical blocks that he can levitate, as well as some planking skills, which are very new. Just moving on here. I hope everyone's been having a good time. Okay. This is great. Ow. Oh, there's 2 of them. Why are there 2 of them? This isn't good. Nice. Does anyone else surprise themselves by doing stuff like that? I frequently do. Alright, so here would be an excellent opportunity to use my wizard guy to make this a little more functional. In my first couple of videos, I talked a lot about how beautiful this game is, and it still impresses me at all times. All the levels are slightly different, and so you end up being, with these characters, and one thing I've noticed is that they all have their uses. You have to use all of them in order to get through, with any... Actually, you just have to use all 3 of them to get through. But the levels themselves are really beautifully done. And that's one thing that I really admire about this game, is that it's so beautiful to look at, and everything, like whether they're in caves or in a tomb or whatever, they're all just a little bit different, and they're just pretty wonderful. So that's nice. And I find, again, like I don't really play a whole lot of puzzle games usually, so this is something that it's not what I asked for. Yeah, I find like the puzzle game is new for me in general, just because I'm not used to playing that kind of these kinds of games, and so it's a really neat challenge for me to sort of try and make this functional. But we'll see here. All right, so moving on. Can I jump? No, I can't jump up there. That's unfortunate. Okay, let's give this another try. Watching somebody else play a puzzle game may be fun. I'm not really sure. I hope you guys are handling it okay. If you're still watching, that is. I know there's this hand thing down here, which I'm sure is very useful. This looks like it moves, now that I think about it. I can't move while I do my little magic thing. Can this break open? Is that a thing that can happen? Ugh. No. Okay. One thing I mentioned, I think, in my last video is that the physics of this game are really interesting. I'm not really sure if they're working, like if the physics are programmed in or not, but I do like how, in a lot of cases, like if there's environments you can interact with, such as, this one is not a very good example because you can't interact with this apparently, but one of the examples is that there's like wooden boards and whatnot that you can use and break, and I really like that. That would be really cool if I could make it work. Shoot. Yeah, it's like, I love that the environments you can interact with them, and that you have to interact with them using, whatever physics the game has to break certain things open and to make proper use of them. I'm not really sure where I'm supposed to go at this point. This has happened a couple of times where it's like, the game is very largely linear, but there's moments where it's not super obvious where to go. And I assume that because, unless I can go through here, which would kind of make sense. I thought at first that I had to go up. But can I? No, that doesn't look like a thing I can do. Well, can I punch through? There's that. Speaking of interesting physics, that's breakable. Note to self: try things before you complain. Yeah, super neat. Oh no, can you, ow. Oh, that should have been a hit, come on. There we go. That's a little rough. Get some health back there. That is one thing that I find, I have recently found frustrating with this game, is just that, like, there's so much to look at, and it's really beautiful, and maybe this is just me not being used to you know, the way that things are, but I find that, especially when enemies are spawning and I try to get out of the way, like, my character will interact with an object and try and push it as opposed to actually fighting while I'm trying to, like, use the bow, and it just... it gets a little confusing. Well, let's be real. But, let's see what I can do with this. Shoot here, maybe? No, we're not. Okay, she doesn't want to shoot down. That's fine. I have other ways. Let's see if I can just push this down here. Okay, and then I'm guessing... oh, that's not good. Come on. Come on, little sir. Oh, that worked. Lovely. I guess I can jump. Okay, I guess not. That's fine. We will... We'll work with it. These puzzles are very fun. I enjoy them a lot. And then there's that little guy down there. So this... woo! This little fella. Get wrecked. I use the knight here the least, for sure. Just because he doesn't have as much mobility and... well, actually, I think that's totally fake. I think he does have the exact same amount of mobility, but... because he doesn't have any projectiles or have the ability to do the same thing as the wizard does, I just don't use him. Oh, that's not good. Oh, what happened to... oh, nope. Oh, jumped right into that one. Saw that coming. No. So, the thief is... again, I said the wizard is my favorite character, and I think he is in terms of functionality, but... this girl's my definite favorite, because I'm a bit of a wuss, and I like to not fight things head-on, as it were. Oh! I can go underwater. Okay. I'm happy. I'm really happy. This is so nice. And I've got a little breathing meter. Oh, can I just have a moment? This is just the greatest. I love... okay. So, for those of you who don't know me, probably most of you, I've got a real thing for water. I love it so much that if I could live in it, I would. It's hard to do considering human skin is not meant to live underwater, but it's a definite deep desire of mine to be able to live underwater like this. So I just love it. I think it's fantastic, and I wish that there's more underwater play in a lot of video games, actually, because there's been some that, in a lot of survival games, I find that you end up playing up in underwater a lot. I remember playing Uncharted, Drake's Fortune, I think it was. The first one I played was actually the third one. And, yeah, I remember just really just loving so much the first couple scenes where you end up being underwater. It's just too good. And, again, not frequent enough. Are they not gonna come down here? You guys are spooky. Well, good for me, I guess. Hiya. Oh, I missed. Come here. Whoop, and you dropped that. Oh, come on. This is hilarious. I don't really think I'm meant to be fighting this guy from down here. Oh, there goes that. Okay, that's fine. This is fine. He's not gonna come in here. Haha! Excellent. One more. Nice. Cool. That's fun. Alright, back up we go. Ooh. I like that these characters, like, hop regally out of the water like dolphins. I don't particularly like dolphins, but these characters are really fun. Gonna probably delete all of these shenanigans because I don't really think you guys need to watch me struggle with this as much as I am, so I'll just alrighty, here we go. Let's see, going back to my thief girl here. What else is up there? Any expedients? I don't think so. This will be fun, and some... Oh, wow, I really missed on that one. Hey, he ducked. There we go, that's fine. And we're back to almost full health, it's not so bad. I think this guy looks like it's on a track, so if I do this, can we slide? No? Can't slide. Okay. I was wrong. Oh, I totally can, I just don't have to wait for it. Again, this is where that physics thing comes in handy if I can actually go pull further. I'm just like, I'm gonna go out of frame here. No, all right, that's fine. We can do, our wizard can help with this one. Oh. I make things so easy for myself, don't I? I really wanted to use my grappling hook. That would've been super cool, like, oh yeah, and then you just go this way, this block. But no, I had to mess it up. Way to go, Sockie. Way to go. I mentioned in my last video as well that how much I've been playing Overwatch, and it's great because I made a post on Tumblr a little while ago just for people to add me on Battle.net if they wanted to play with me, and it's actually gotten such a great response. I've had so many people just approach me and and play with me, and it's such a great experience because, again, like, you know, there are a lot of community-based games like Pokemon Go and whatnot where, you know, you're actually physically out doing things, but I find Overwatch, like, it's really more fun if you have people to play with, and I've just noticed that people want to make friends, and it's really great most of the time, so I've been really thankful for the experience of having people want to play with me and add me as often as they do, so it's really, really grateful for that. I wonder... I'm just gonna see what's down here. If there's anything, I don't know if this is something that I'm supposed to be coming down to. Yes. Wow, that went down super deep. Is that a fish? Oh, this is so beautiful. I can't even begin to describe how much I enjoy this. This is so wonderful. Okay, I'm just gonna go explore and see if there's anything else. I know that I have to go in there because that's where the save point is, but I'm just gonna go back and see if there's anything else that I missed down here in the depths, like this experience. Thank you. And anything else on this side here? Oh, this is too beautiful. How does everybody not want to live underwater? It's just amazing. Summer dip. Nice achievement. Thanks, game. Alright, away I go. Back down. If anyone has any doubts about this, blue is my favorite color. This is why, because it's the water. It's gorgeous. It's beautiful. Alright. There's that. I wonder now what the best way to get up there is. Let me have a quick- Oh, it's a box. Okay. Wonderful. Wonderful! Alright, so this is a box. That's not what I wanted. I fell. Oops. Okay, so where's my shoreline here? I guess it's right here. So I'll put this here where the ground is solid. And, oh! I find this like... I remember when I was really young and I was playing Super Mario and whatnot for the first time, I ended up really, really wishing that I had better control, like, you know, better control of the game and whatnot, because I remember just those places where Mario would just, like, slip and slide all over the place, and it used to drive me absolutely nuts, because I'd be so careful not to, you know, run off the edge or step too far, and I would just, like, slide right off at the worst moment. I'm sure everyone's had the same experience with Mario. I don't know how that happened. Alright, this is providing a bit of a challenge. I'll just stab myself in the face. Because I'm not really sure how to get up there, and there's nothing that, again, were I a... Oh, I'm in the water. There's no ground over there. Good to know. Okay. Yeah, there's a... Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. I'm stuck. I'm stuck. There we go. Yeah, I'm not really sure what I can really hang on to over here, so that's a potential issue. Can make a couple boxes, I guess. Let's see what we can do here. Can I get up there? Oh, nope. Not with its... I'm amazing. just a casual stab in the face. Let me just walk right into this. Thank you. Okay. Unorthodox, but it works. And what did I just do? I broke something. This is fine. I'm gonna switch to my here thief girl. Actually, no, that's dumb. I will go back to my wizard. I will make myself a plank, which is... didn't mean for it to go there, but that's okay. Oh, poor guy. And here I go, over Dan's experience. Anything else over here that I can get? Yeah, that's it. Okay, perfect. I'm so sorry. That's all right, we'll just do this again. That's fine. All right, it gets stuck on me. Here we go, all right. Let's try this again, shall we? Can we jump? Yeah, perfect. I really should change the jump button from the my W key because it's like forward, but there is no really forward, so there's my problem, but. And this looks dangerous. This looks like something I would fall into if I didn't fall into it. I'm awesome. I was gonna say if I wasn't me, assuming that I would fall into it, but this doesn't look good. This looks like I'm definitely gonna fall in, so I'm gonna go ahead and see. This is like, again, I don't really need, woo! Oh, okay. I guess I don't really need these planks for anything, but I find them very helpful. And I don't feel bad about using them, whereas like I think in other games, like I would try and get through like not the hardest way, but this game is hard enough for my brain that I'm really just enjoying giving it a solid try with all the skills that I have. And I can't wait to level these characters up too. Like these characters have great powers and I'm excited to see where they go. I don't know if this will work, but let's- Oh! I don't know if you guys heard that, but there's that really evil laughter. I'm not sure what that was, but that was scary. That was some scary nonsense. Let's see, what have I got here? Enchanted mana crystal. That sounds kind of nice. What do we do with that one? Enchanted mana crystal increases the effect of each collected mana vial by 20%. Because no one else uses mana, I'm just gonna give it to the wizard. Sorry, I'm sitting on my pants. Ugh. Okay, and I'm guessing now we have to go underwater, so I shall... Oh, I can't move that because I'm dead. Okay, this is gonna be interesting. Wow, yeah, I really can't. Okay, I wonder then if my... my strong fellow here can... Okay, perfect. Oh, he swims too. That's great. He says agile and lithe. Actually, props to that guy for being able to swim in all that armor. I'm, again, not sure if there's any sort of difference in their ability to breathe underwater. Well, not breathe underwater, but their stamina, I guess. But that guy deserves mad props because that's tough. Can I not crouch? I can't crouch apparently. That sucks. Oh, and I'm underwater again. Okay. I'll take it. Haha! Alright, so the knight is pretty useful. He's a helpful kind of guy. Did he breathe fire at me? That was so neat. I was wondering what those guys would do. I guess the fire still hurt. Am I getting shot at? Oh, I sure am. Okay. Good to know. I won't make that mistake again. I guess I also have more skill points, which is neat. I don't know that I can do much at this point with those skill points, if I've got enough to make that a thing. Let me just do that now and just see if I have any ability to upgrade. Upgrade cost 3. Oh. I can upgrade my plank. I can have 2 planks. I like that. I think that's really important. And I can give the knight a temporary speed boost that can be directed towards enemies to knock them back. Okay. Oh, and I still haven't figured out how to use the gravity shield. That's probably important. Yes. And yes. And you, I can't upgrade. I can upgrade the bow. No, I can't. Okay. Carrying on. Moving on. Ha! Yes. I'm like occasionally getting the hang of this. It's not perfect. It's not always great, but. Ooh. That was so close. But let's see also if I'm you, little lady. I like how it's right, and she can't shoot very far down. That's why I'm not being able to do this. So, but it is coming down nice and low, which is a great start. Hi-ya! Yeah, perfect. Oh, I missed. Ooh. Will you keep shooting me in the water? You sure will. It sparkles. I like that. Oh, I guess I'm gonna go down. Okay. Sort of getting it. I am very stuck. This is not good. See, this is a bit of a problem. Can I- oh. I want to kill this guy just so I can get out of here with the least amount of stress possible. There we go. Perfect. Alright, so how am I gonna get out of here? I don't think I can jump high enough. This is a slight problem. I don't think that the game was meant for this. Maybe I can shoot that? Nope. This isn't good. Okay, I'm actually going to stop the episode here for now, and I will figure this out next time. So thank you guys very much for watching. If you like the video, please click like, obviously, and subscribe down below. My name is Sockie again, and this channel has 4 other lovely gamers right now. Artists, gamers, movie reviewers, everything that you could ever possibly want in a channel. So please, please let us know what you think, comments, what have you. And I will see you all in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.